Hello and welcome to Stern FX. In this tutorial, I'll show you the basics of Mocha Ae, arguably the best tracker tool we have in After Effects. So look at this guy. He's sitting at this bus stop, minding his own business, reading a book, and not even realize that the classic video game is about to be projected on the big sign here. Well, I think he suspects that something is wrong because towards the end of the clip, he's looking at it. Okay, so let's make it happen. We'll do it, or more accurately, I will do it, using the Mocha AE plugin, which is bundled inside After Effects. Your job, by the way, is just to stay with me until the end of this video, because tracking and matching the sign is just half of the story here. I'll also pass along a few valuable compositing tips and share more complex examples towards the end. But let's not get ahead of ourselves and start from the beginning, which is to track this shot. So I'll select the bus stop comp, and then I'll go to Effect. And under Boris FX Mocha, you can launch the Mocha plugin. By the way, there is another way to do it. You can go to the animation menu and you can choose this command, track in Boris FX Mocha. This is going to switch us to the effect controls because, of course, this is a plugin and we need to click on the Mocha logo to launch the plugin. Now, in case you don't know, Mocha AE is an award-winning planner tracking and masking plugin that is bundled inside After Effects. It's designed to solve difficult motion tracking shots with ease, and the idea here is that instead of tracking pixels, we are tracking the texture, or to be more exact, the planner. And sometimes this method offers a better solution than the point tracker. Now, Mocha AE has a bigger brother named Mocha Pro, which can do more than just tracking. You can use it to rotoscope, stabilize shot, mesh warping, stereoscopic 3D work, camera solving, and other stuff. If you want to learn more, I've included a link to the official website of the product in the description of this video. But now we're going to use the core ability, which is to track this sign surface and then replace it with our own footage. So I'll start by selecting the rectangle X spline layer. I'll click on it, and then I'll mark here around this sign, and I'm going to move those points to be on top of the sign texture. Now, I'm not sure if you noticed, but this sign is going to leave the screen. I'm not going to bother with the area that I want to replace. I just want to make sure that I'm including the surface area here, or the planner, the texture that Mocha is going to look for. I'll tick the perspective option, and after this very long build-up, I'll track forward by clicking on this button. Now, it's also worth to mention that Mocha can utilize your GPU in order to speed up tracking. So you can see in the upper right corner that this is actually happening on my machine. Also notice that the frame leaves the screen, or actually the area that we are tracking. And this doesn't really bother Mocha because there is enough information underneath to track accurately the surface. So I'm just going to take the current time indicator and move it all the way to the beginning of the shot. And then the next step is to click on Show Planner Surface, or the Surface tool. Option 6, if you want to call it from the keyboard. And this is the area that we're going to use inside After Effects. So I need to place those corners at the edge of the screen. Now, to help me do it more accurately, I'll go to the View menu and show you that you can show different overlays. For example, Alt 8 or Option 8 here on the Mac is going to give you a temporary zoom window or windows. So let's enable it. And now if I'm going to grab one of the corners, I will have a magnified view, a zoom view, so I can see exactly where I need to place the corner. So this is something which I highly recommend for you to use when you are attaching the surface to the edge of the desired plane. Another thing worth checking is the planner grid. And this is this pink grid over here. If I'll enable it and then play the clip and verify that the perspective is matched to the surface that you are tracking, it will go back and forth. And it's really important to actually do this number and play it from beginning to end and then in reverse. This way you can spot errors. I'll switch off the planner grid now, and I'm also going to go to the layer properties. This is just another check that I can do to make sure that everything works here. I can bring on an external clip by using this input method. I can use the Mocha logo, but in this case, I might as well use one of the built-in grids. So let's go with this one, 16 by 16. And again, I'm going to play this just to verify that nothing is moving. Now, obviously, this is a very simple example. Towards the end of this tutorial, I will show you something a little bit more complex. But once you understand how this works, then everything should work exactly the way you expect it. Another good idea is to name your tracking layers. So in this case, I'll name it Sine. And obviously, you can have more than one layer and you can track them simultaneously. All right, I think this is it for this step. So I'll save my progress and then I'll close the plugin window. Now I wish to apply the tracking data to the Donkey Kong screen clip that I've captured from the arcade Japanese version of this game. To make this work, we needed to do some prep work. And the first thing that we need to do is to make sure that this layer is the same dimensions and frame rate of the composition that we are using. So the easiest way to work here is to select the layer, go to the layer menu, and then under transform, use this command, fit to comp, command option F here on the Mac, control alt F on the Windows side. Now, this is not enough. We also need to go back to the layer menu and pre-compose this clip. So the transformations are going to be baked inside this composition. I'll make sure to move all the attributes into the new composition. I'll then remove the suffix, just naming this Donkey Kong screen should be enough. We don't need to open the new composition. I'm just going to click OK. All right, now let's go to the beginning. And momentarily, I'm going to switch off the visibility of this layer and select the bus stop layer, which has the Mocha plugin applied to. I'll open up the tracking data, and then I'll need to click on Create Track Data. And this is going to show me all the layers that I have inside the plugin. In my case, just the sign. So I'll click OK. And you can see that we have four corners at the edge of this sign. And this is what we need. We want to export the corner pin. Actually, let's do the corner pin with motion blur support. This is the second option over here. And then all we need to do is just choose the layer that we want to export to. So in our case, the Donkey Kong screen. And finally, we're going to click Apply Export. I'll just enable the visibility of the layer so we can see immediately how this works after I'm clicking the Apply Export button. So the first step here is to check the tracking result. So just press spacebar to preview the result and make sure that everything looks correct, especially when it leaves the screen. And this is something that the perspective corner pin, the built-in four-point corner pin inside After Effects can't handle. All right, now we need to make it look as believable as possible. So I'll select the Donkey Kong layer and I'll go to the layer menu. And first, under layer styles, because this is assigned, I want to create some inner shadow, which is precisely what this layer style will help us do. So I'll open it up here in the timeline and I'll play with the size. Let's just switch it on and off. And you can see the contribution, but it's really hard to tell that it's there. So to match the colors a bit better, I'll go to the effect menu and from the color correction category, I'll add the levels effect. And I'm going to take the output black and move it until the black of the sign are going to be matched more or less to the black levels of the external video. I'll do the same thing for the output white. So I'm just eyeballing it, but this is going to help this digital screen to blend on top of the real footage. Another thing you can do is go to the effect menu and under noise and grain, add the noise HLS auto to help us match the grain in the video. So usually I'll start by changing this pop-up menu to grain and then start to play with the lightness. So let's raise it to 3 and then to see if this helps, I'll hold down the option alt on Windows and using my mouse scroller, I'll scroll up. And this is going to help you examine the level of grain that you are adding. I think we went too far, so I may want to reduce it to maybe 2. I think this is going to work. Even 1, maybe 1.5. This starts to look more in line with the video underneath. All right, I'll close both of those effects. And I'm going to go to the effect menu once again. And this time from the stylized category, I'll add the glow effect. Because if this is self-illuminate sign, it needs to glow a bit. I'll change the glow radius to 30 and then I'll tap to the intensity and lower it to 0.5. So this is the before and after. I think it helps to sell the illusion. And I'm going to close everything. And if I want, I can also preview this just to see the intermediate result. Now, again, I want to tell a bit of a story, not just show you the technical way of how to track something and match it to the shot. So I want to create a transition to blink this sign so it will replace the original one that was there and therefore will make more sense for this person to look at it. So let's go over here after 1 second and say 10 frames and I'll select again the Donkey Kong screen and this time I'll go to Effect, Transition, and I'll add the Venetian blinds. I'll change the transition completion to something that I can see. So let's start with 50%. Of course, we're going to animate it. And then I can work with the direction just to match it to the angle that we are seeing over here. And I'll change the width to, let's go with 7. So something like this. And then we can animate it. So I'll start with 100% for the transition completion, create a keyframe over here, and then I'll move 2 frames by pressing page down twice, and I'll change it back to 0. Now I want to see those keyframes, so I'll double click on the Venetian blinds effect, and this is going to expose it here in the timeline, and then I'll select those 2 keyframes, I'll copy them to the clipboard by pressing, of course, Command C, and then I'll move 2 frames forward, pressing page down will do the trick, and I'll paste the same animation. I'll do this once more, and the distance between those keyframes doesn't really need to be 2 frames, so you can maybe move the keyframes just to create some sort of a fluorescent effect. So this is how it looks. And to add additional distortion, I'll go back to the effect window, and from the distort category, I'll add the last one, the wave warp effect. I'll change the wave height to 50 and then the wave width to 1. And to make sure the distortion is not going outside of the boundaries of the layer, I'll use the pinning option and pin it to all edges. Now I'll go back to my first keyframe, so 1 second and 10 frames, and I'll create a keyframe for the wave height. I'll move to the last keyframe that I've created for the Venetian blinds effect, and then I'll change the wave height to 4, and then around 3 seconds and 15 frames, I'm going to create additional movement. So I'll take it to a negative value, let's say minus 12, and then move forward just a bit to create another glitch if you like, and set it to not 0, maybe 2, just to leave a bit of a warping effect. Now, of course, we can change the orders of the effect. We can take both the Venetian blinds and the wave warp effect and take them above the glow, maybe even above everything. And I think it's going to look better if I'm going to go back into the Donkey Kong screen and enable the sound effect that we have for the game itself. And then I'm also going to click on the shy icon to show you that I have 2 static sound effects that I'm going to enable. And I'll go back to the beginning, I'll maximize this screen, and I'll preview this composition. And I think it looks quite convincing, mostly thanks to the good foundation of the corner pin tracking that we've got out of Mocha AE. Now here's another example of a couple in a gallery looking at another level from the same game, only to be amazed from this worker who decides just like that to carry off this artwork from the hall. Both of the tracking and the rotor work in this case are courtesy of Mocha AE, and this is what's helping to sell this shot. Of course, we're only scratching the surface of what's possible with this plugin, but hopefully this was a good starting point for you to try it out and dive deeper if needs be. But this is it for this time. As always, thank you so much for sticking until the end. You earned the right to take a break and play a retro game.
Hello, Mario.